Terry had the same sort of intensity, I think, has the same intensity that John has when he's doing his work. I mean, it's really, you feel there's this barely contained explosion in there. I mean, he's not one to sit back like Graham with a pipe doing a crossword puzzle. Gilliam's, it's something's happening. It's always something happening. It's happening in my body, and my body is about to burst out, and I can control these bits.
I think Terry, he can only operate in opposition. He has to have an enemy. I don't think his juices run unless he's fighting against somebody. When he was doing the animations for the TV shows, he was fighting against the BBC and fighting against the animation department.
He has a relatively small vocabulary, I suppose. He says bunch a lot, when he means a lot. I remember him when we were flying over, we were doing a tour of Canada, and we were flying over the Great Lakes, and Terry looked out of the window and said, "Hey, you guys, a whole bunch of water." Which really sums Terry up, I think.
Also, Terry was the kind of the outsider, the American come in to a lot of sort of Oxbridge performers brought up in Footlights and Revue and all that, and he came from a kind of different tradition. So that was good, you know, and he took a sort of different view and stepped slightly outside the rest of us, stopped us all becoming a bit precious.
I had nothing at stake because my material seemed to be beyond either comprehension or criticism, because I just did something that was so different from the others. So when everybody would be reading out the material, it was always a fairly, you know, tense moment, because people were trying to judge the moment to read their bit out, because if you read thing out too early, it would get dumped into the wrong pile. And there was always this jockeying for